it's Susan here from Komori no Hime Cosplay, and welcome back to the 20 Years of Anime project, in which we count down to the year 2020 using costumes. Today we're going to be going back to 2012 and making the dress for Asuna from Sword Art Online. However, instead of her default version, we're going to be making her Halloween promotional artwork outfit. To make Asuna's dress, we're going to be using Cutso. This is pattern number 32, their Moonrise Mod pattern. And I'm using this one because it had the silhouette that I was looking for. And for the fabric, I'm going to be using a keepsake calico that I got from Joann's. It's a thin black and white stripe fabric. The reference image has fabric with thicker stripes, but unfortunately this was the closest I could find. Alternatively, if you want, you could use a fabric that's a bit more accurate, or you can use a base fabric and then sew the stripe designs to the fabric. So I cut out the skirt front and the two skirt back pieces and sewed them together along the side seam. Now this pattern is essentially a circle skirt, and because of that, portions of the skirt are on the bias, so they tend to droop over time. So I just kept the skirt on my dress form for a couple days to give the fabric a chance to sag before I attach it to the dress. So now I'm going to take the skirt off of the dress form and trim away any of the excess fabric along the bottom. Taking the front panel of the dress bodice, I sewed the darts according to the placement marked on the pattern, and then zigzagged all around the edges to keep them from fraying. Moving on to the back of the dress, there is supposed to be a dart in each of these pieces. However, last time I wore a costume made from this pattern, it was a little tight around the waist. So instead of gathering the skirt to fit, I'm just going to not put in these darts. Hopefully that won't mess things up too terribly. But since there's going to be a corset over the dress, if things don't match up, that hopefully won't be too bad, even though technically that is what you're supposed to be doing at this point in the pattern. Sew the front of the bodice to the back of the bodice pieces, along the shoulder seams, and along the side seams. Sew the bodice onto the skirt. Moving on to the collar, we're going to cut four of the collar pieces out of some plain black cotton. On two of the pieces, apply some fusible interfacing. Then we're going to match an interfaced and non-interfaced collar piece, putting right sides together, and sew them together along the edge, leaving the top open. Turn the collar pieces right side out and press them flat. Then we're going to zigzag along the top edge to hold the two pieces together. Attach the collar to the dress using whatever method you prefer. The pattern calls for using a French seam, however, I decided to finish the edge with bias tape. Sew the back pieces of the dress together and install a zipper. Since Asuna's dress has puff sleeves, I'm going to be taking the Cutso number 23, the Maid Cafe pattern, and just taking the puffed sleeve piece, and I'm going to trim away the bottom so that it's straight along the bottom instead of curved. Cut two of them out of the fabric, zigzag along the edges, and then on the bottom edge, I'm going to fold it up and sew it into place to create a channel for the elastic. Cut a piece of elastic to the desired length and thread it through the channel that we made at the bottom of the sleeve and tack it into place on either end. Then we're going to fold our sleeve so that the right sides are together and sew it together along the side. Gather the sleeves and sew them onto the bodice. The bottom hem of the dress is not seen in the reference image, so there's not really a particular length or design that goes along the bottom of it, so you can interpret it however you want. I decided to add some black cotton ruffles to the bottom and also included some bat laser cut felt trim that I got from Joann's during the Halloween season, and to make the bats a little bit more noticeable, I hand sewed on some orange beads in between each of them. To give the dress a little more poof, I layered it over an old small petticoat, and with that, Asuna's dress is done! Overall, I'm pretty pleased with how it turned out. I think it looks cute just as a dress, even without the rest of the costume being finished. I hope you found this video helpful. For more cosplay tutorial videos, please subscribe, and thank you very much for watching.